shot. Finally, a Hepsi to the chicken, who finally got everything he deserved over the years. Yes, folks, you can call it poultry in motion.
Gary Gaetti, the G-man, with a long fly to left field to Mike Greenwell. Now watch this throw. Greenwell trying to get the man. He...
Yeah. Now, that's Dale Earnhardt in front. Bill Elliott trying to pass in the Winston 500. Earnhardt down low, cuts Elliott off. Earnhardt up high, cuts Elliott off again. Heck, you'd get tickets from a cop for doing that. Earnhardt won the race, and then during the victory lap, watch what happens. Elliott gives Earnhardt a little more than a love tap. He's Dr. Strange Glove Award to Scott Fletcher of Texas, who had the double play ball in sight, but booted it badly. Best way to meet somebody, watch Reggie Williams, left fielder of L.A., looking at the girl in the front row. He makes the catch, slams into her, and got her phone number late. Now, most revealing pickoff, Mike Kingery of Seattle, who's rarely seen with his baseball helmet off, if ever. Here, oh boy, what a revealing pickoff that is. I didn't know Kingery had such little hair. The Cy Sperling Award, if you will.
Fun. The step with two left feet. Now that's what I call stepping to the beat. They say it's all a simple matter of balance, timing, and rhythm. And big leaguers are just like the rest of us. You know, some of us have it, and some of us, well.
Gearhart of Baltimore with a miscalculation.
That's me. I would have done that.
Corey Snyder of the Indians with a pop fly to center. Claudel Washington of the Yankees with no idea. To the sport of boxing, watch the referee, Chris Wallison, and he gets the worst of that fly.
Yeeman.
Here is the low blow of the pass. Oh. Boxing's most bizarre moment of 1987, they both connect. It is a double knockdown. Baseball had its share of embarrassment. Here's a ground ball to Joey Cora of San Diego. Plays it with a neat underhand toss. Not what he had in mind. Confusion between Tony Fernandez and George Bell of Toronto, and they calmly talk it over.
Yeah.
Brian Downing of the Angels with a line drive foul right at the television cameraman.
Oh!
But he's tough. He hangs right in. Now keep an eye on the catcher, Chris Bando of Cleveland, on the attempted steal a bit off the mark. To the wild and wacky in hockey, Gilbert Delorme of Detroit checked into the Edmonton bench, and they refused to let him get out. Here is Anton Stastny on a breakaway. Ulf Samuelson of Hartford trying all he can to no avail. Now, before the puck is dropped, before the opening faceoff, before the game gets underway, Montreal and Quebec are going at each other. How about Jay Miller of Boston? A bit upset. Now, watch this. Things just not working out for Jay. Some sensational shots in basketball. Julius Erving from out of bounds with a fling, and it goes in. Woo. How about this heave by 15-year-old Jason Freeman in a pickup game? And then there was Mark Bailey of Heath, Ohio, with one of the wild shots of the year. Whole moving screen. Back to baseball. Eddie Murray with a pop foul. Now here comes Steve Buschel of Texas to the seats with the catch. Wow. Off the pop-up, Kevin Mitchell, the Padres, says, I've got it. Gary Templeton says, no, you don't. And Templeton with the catch. Giant pitcher Roger Mason with an apparent base hit, but Andre Dawson is able to gun him down. Now we close with the unusual in the 60-yard sprint. Ben Johnson shows his speed and goes over the barrier. Yannick Noah with the shot off the post, but Andres Gomez with a nifty return. Darryl Thomas of Indiana with an attempted in-bounds pass, giving a facial. And Portland Trailblazer VP Harry Glickman with an awards presentation before a Portland game.
The all-time scoring record for the Portland Trailblazers was 9,702. 9,000. Let me look.
Things get too hot to handle. The result is summertime blues. I'm a glory of a bus, I'm
a glory of a horror. He has no recollection of the accident, which he lost a ski and cartwheeled near the bottom of the course. He was airlifted by helicopter to hospital. The 29-year-old says he still plans to continue skiing until the 1988 Olympics.
Seen game-winning touchdowns before. This one exceptional. A game-winner on the desperation pass. So Brownsburg High School beats Hobart High in the final seconds. Now watch this, the aftermath. It starts slowly, and here they come. To basketball hotshots, John Paxson of the Chicago Bulls with the off-balance fling at the buzzer. Michael Cooper of the LA Lakers does it from half court with a bomb. Now, how about this nifty halftime show featuring the Dixie Daredevils?
Yeah!
In the world of hockey, Tom Laidlaw of the Rangers with a crunching move on Al Iafredi of Toronto. Here is the punch out of the month. Dwight Schofield of the Caps with a first round TKO of Craig Cox of Vancouver. And Dale Hawerchuk of Winnipeg saying, take a seat, and he took one too. Most graceful moments this past month. Intercepted pass by way of the deflection off a teammate's helmet. Here's the round mound of rebound. Charles Barkley of the Sixers give him a 9.5. The Phoenix Suns mascot, the gorilla, obviously with an identity crisis. Back to basketball. Larry Bird with the pass, and it goes through the legs of Tree Rollins, but the shot is missed. Here's Jay Vincent of Dallas with a pass to no one. And this will not improve the shooting percentages of the Philadelphia 76ers, although it does help their offensive rebounding stats. Nice teamwork here. Mike Richardson of the Nets with a pass to the face of Buck Williams.
Hello.
To the unusual, Ben Wilson of the Chicago Blackhawks with the carom shot, Willie Moscone style, and it goes right in. And here's a new one for us, a St. Louis Blues player using a teammate as a tissue. Now, if that wasn't embarrassing enough, Robert Reed of Houston attempted jump shot. Nice try. Ken Bannister of the Knicks on the jump ball attempt. And to the world of play-by-play broadcasters, the Detroit Pistons announcers in their on-camera receive the unexpected. And watch this between periods interview attempt at a Boston Bruins game. Not a welcome visitor.
Raspberry of the year to Shane Churla of Binghamton, who touched off a brawl with that horrible shot to the groin area and almost helped kill a fan as a teammate attempted a haymaker punch and just missed. Watch right here. The player goes after the...
Hits you when you're down.
Of the week, Al Secord and Wayne Presley of Chicago locking horns, but the winners here, the lead duo of Rick Vive and Steve Thomas. Ouch! Quite the collision in the center ice area. Most embarrassing moment, Ron Flockhart of the St. Louis Blues thinks he has the puck. It's behind you, buddy. Now, a hevesy to the chicken. Yes, that mad chicken for this attempted affection on a Chicago Bulls cheerleader. Fortunately, this young lady had a sense of humor and wouldn't take this foul move by the chicken. Lying down here, she belts him with the pom-pom, belts him with another one, and finally makes him get off the court. In the category of bloody beautiful, a hevesy to 7'6" Manute Bol. The swinging Sudanese here gets tied up by the Boston Celtics and then goes crazy and almost connects with that shot. Now, folks, you bet. The award for most innovative goal, Michael Pavanka of Washington with the old Taparino over the shoulder of the New York Islander goalie, Kelly Rudy. And if you don't believe this attempted patty cake, watch it again as he taps it over everybody's shoulder and it finds the mark. Finally, to the punch out of the week, Pernell Whitaker against Roger Mayweather. That's Whitaker with his back to you. Watch the left hook right to the face of the referee, Chris Wollison, who got a little too close for comfort, and the crowd loved it. And we loved it so much, we've got the replay. Watch this left. Out.
Same place, different opponent, same man. Willie Huber with a bouncer from center ice that gets by Pittsburgh's Pat Riggin.
accident, Mets catcher Barry Lyons chases this Jack Clark pop-up to the dugout, over, falls into the dugout, and unfortunately collides with Cardinal pitcher John Tudor, who was sitting on the bench at the time. He's now got a broken bone in his knee, and he'll be out for 3 months' time. Best impersonation of Sugar Ray Leonard. Sean Dunston of the Cubs, who got brushed back once by Andy McGaffigan, gets a little more chin music, and then, fortunately, does not land that punch. McGaffigan ducks out of the way. Neither player was ejected. Worst boot in baseball. Two outs and a tie game in the ninth inning. Braves and Giants, and here's Glenn Hubbard with an easy force. Unfortunately, he's from the Bill Buckner School of Fielding, and the Giants win. Finally, most macho player in Major League Baseball, Steve Garvey of the Padres. Here, he gets hit right in the chin by Kelly Downs. Does he flinch? No. A little bit of blood? Yeah, you...
He's hurt. The one you love. The one you shouldn't hurt at all. You always take the sweetest rose and crush it till the petals fall. It's because I love you most of all.
Utah's Thurl Bailey for the softest touch. Look at this one. No basket, but no rebound either. You got to get one of the tall guys to bring it down from there. Best desperation shot. Portland's Jerome Kersey here with a couple seconds to go. Nails this three-pointer.
He doesn't want to be nervous. Now, here's a guy pointing to everybody. Now, watch what happens. I'll take it. He helps everybody out, and he took it. Now, here's where I was. Whoops. Well, he's got bad control. Watch this guy. Oh. Here's my favorite, though, John. Watch where he throws it. That was the perfect pitch. Now, watch the guy holding the bat. Now, you got to have a good grip on the bat. Watch where it lands. Look at this guy. Watch this bat.
Beautiful. Oh, my God.
Someday I'd like to see a guy pick up a bat and throw it to the first baseman. Look at the fan.
Clear understand?
He got mad. Two errors on the same play. This guy misses it. Watch this guy. See ya. Here comes two guys out at home plate. A double play. Zone.
Got them both.
Zone. Now watch this. Here's what I love.
Look at the birds.
See the pigeons flew there? Now watch the pigeons. They stop the game. Now they try to catch this bird. No, they're going to catch it. Now, a dog doesn't show up, but a cat does. Watch this. Watch this. Watch it. Watch what happens. This guy's so brave. Watch.
Ah!
Wrappings and ribbons are the usual requirement. What we offer are suggestions for after retirement. Mike Foligno of Buffalo's first on our list. This talented saver we just couldn't resist. He moves the puck to deep goalie zone. And when he scores, watch him jump and shout. So what do we suggest this dynamo do when his hockey career is over and through? We'd like to see him at the head of the class teaching a...
But you can still get eight guys in it if you try. Washington and Los Angeles established the record. And after, here's Steve Sachs of the Dodgers looking for a pop-up. He says, I got it, and he's got it. Oh, right in the nose, though. Unfortunately, Sachs is okay, but his ego's bruised. Best save, Conn Smythe winner, Ron Hextall of the Flyers. The guy was fantastic, even though Edmonton won the Stanley Cup. Look at this amazing save here as he flops around like a beach whale and sticks the glove out for the save. Best pass, Isaiah Thomas of the Detroit Pistons, a blind feed to Dennis Rodman. A beauty? Yes, but Isaiah also threw the worst pass of last week, right to Larry Bird, who fed Dennis Johnson. The Celtics beat the Pistons. Best play by a shortstop, Spike Owen of Boston robs Julio Franco here, score at 6-3, and put a star beside it. Now, David Palmer of the Atlanta Braves shows a little style here against Jerry Mumphrey of the Cubs. Watch the comebacker, and oh, look at that, behind the back. Look what I found, says Palmer, and he...
This pickoff attempt, Julio Cruz of the White Sox with a tagathon all over Cliff Johnson of Toronto. One more time, some odd moments in baseball. Phil Niekro on Polish American Night at Yankee Stadium. Here's Don Beller. He hits the fly ball. Reed Nichols of the Red Sox with some problems.
Tonight in Adventureland, so fasten your seatbelt for this delight from the Cavs-Atlanta game. It's wild, it's woolly, it's a draw, jump ball. Winner of this week's Mr. Nice Guy Award, the Knicks' Pat Cummings. He couldn't stand the thought of Atlanta's Dominique Wilkins missing, so he tipped the shot in for him. To a cooler arena where things are heating up, the fight started before the clock in this one between New Jersey and Minnesota. New Jersey's Don Lever, number 9, got in the best punch. He nailed referee Ryan Bozak. Here's a case of a referee who was nearly nailed. Bengal fans were bombing this NFL official with snowballs, but like their team, they couldn't score. The Defense Is My Life Award goes to Detroit's Ken Fantetti. After his teammate William Graham made an outstanding diving interception, Fantetti, who can't stand to see anybody running with the ball, tackles his own man. Now a Hall of Shame comparison. The Lakers and Clippers indulge in dueling mascots.